Hello students, in this video we are going to study exploring swing, different visual components, GUI components through which we can create our own GUI. Okay, so these are the components that we are going to see, from J button to J tree. Actually J tree, it is not there in your syllabus, up to J toggle button. Okay, J button, J checkbox, J combo box, J label, J list, J radio button and all. Okay, so first we will go with J label. J label, J label and image icon. J label already you have seen in your swing program, where you have created two buttons, one is alpha, another one is beta, and third one which is displaying message that choose a press a button, or alpha was pressed, beta was pressed, that was a label, J label. Okay, J label can be used to display text or an icon. Okay, at a time you can display a text or you can display a icon or both, you can do. See, I think you have done your assignment using J label. You can achieve that assignment using different components, but I have achieved that using J label. See, what you can do is, if I press some button, first button, then it should display this icon. So icon will be set to a label. So J label can be used to display a text or a icon. Okay, so J label, if you want to just display icon, no text on that label, at that time you are just using this constructor, J label icon, that you want to set to that label. Okay, we'll discuss about this in the next upcoming points. Okay, then J label string, what you want to display on the label. See, now suppose if we have a new frame, example this one, in this, okay, in this, if you have a new frame, so when you if you drag and drop, okay, actually you should not drag and drop. So if you have this label, you can edit a text. See, edit a text, what you want to display, press a button. So this label has now only one component, that is press a button. Okay, see, if you just display this, press a button. Okay, this is what, just a label. Okay, and labels can respond back to your events, it can respond back, but you cannot click on that. Okay, once it is made hyperlink, then only you can click on that, otherwise it can just respond to your button action or any other component actions. Okay, now just a string, if you want to set a icon, you can just have this option here, in this properties, you can go to properties, then here you can have this icon. See, you need to search for that, where it is actually, yes, here, icon, you can set here the icon image for that J label. Okay, with string or without a string, that's all, depends on you. The last one is what, string, icon and the alignment, where this icon and the string should be displayed. The alignment means where this icon and string should be displayed, at the center or the left or the right or at the top or the bottom. Okay, that is what alignment. The alignment argument specifies horizontal alignment of the text or icon within the dimension of the label. So it must be of the left, right, center, leading, trailing. Okay, left, right, center, leading, that you are using in a typewriter or just like a tab, we can say. Okay, then trailing backwards. Notice that icons are specified by the project's type icon, object's type icon. Now here the icon that you are specifying, whatever the icon that you want to set to the label, it is or must and should be of type icon. Here, what is this icon actually? To import the image, first what you need to do is, you need to create the object of an image icon. You need to create an object of an image icon, can be pressed as an, can be passed as an argument to a icon parameter. See, first you need to create a, like this, see, image icon, an object name icc is equal to new image icon, then here you can give a path to a file name. Suppose your image is at C drive, so C something like this. Okay, then image name, image.jpg. Understood? Like this, you can specify. Understood? So once it is created, then this ICC, which is of type image icon, should be passed to this label. This label here, it should be replaced with ICC. Okay, understood? So now, proceeding further, see, the icon and the text associated with the label can be obtained. If you want to query that, what text it is associated to a label. We are having a text called presser button in this label, right? So what has been set to this J label? If you want to query, you can use get text method. These are called getters and setters. Okay, this is very, very important. Get text. Using get text, you can obtain the text that has already been set to a label. If you want to query the icon, you can use just get icon. The return type will be of type icon. Huh? When you are using get text, return type will be a string. Okay, if you want to set on a particular action that you have already done in your assignment, when you click a smile or a happy or a sad, at that time if you click a happy button, it will set a icon. See, set a icon, right? See, if you want to set an icon to a label, at that time you are using set icon. Okay, if you want to change the label, the same method that we have used in your program, alpha and beta button, J label dot set text, alpha was pressed. Alpha was pressed. The message should be passed in this as an argument to this set text. Beta was pressed. Okay, so these are called setters and getters. To get the icon, you need to use get icon. To get the text, you need to use get text. To set the icon, you need to use for label, huh? J label. Set icon, or to set the text, you need to use set text. So you can use, you can see a program on page number 880. See what author is doing here. See, first AWT, then swing. Here we are not handling any kind of event. That's why we don't have here import javax.awt.events. Okay. So here what we are doing is we are creating a swing applet. You are creating a swing applet, J label demo extends a J applet. So whenever you are creating an applet, means you need to write a init method. Then when you are writing here init method, then I have told you that in previous video that this is where you are creating a event dispatcher thread. Event dispatcher thread. Through this only the GUI will be created. Make GUI method you are calling there. So the make GUI method, what it will do is, what it is doing is, it is creating an image icon, the name named as II, where you are setting, you are importing france.gif image into II. Then you are setting your label to France, text is France, and the image is that you have already imported, and it should be at the center. The J label should be at the center. Then you are adding the J label to the content pane. Content pane means your applet. So the output will be like this. Output will be like this. Understood? So that you have already done in your assignment. So proceeding further, we will want to J text field. J text field. So J text field is the simplest swing text component. J text field allows you to edit one line of text. Yes, it is very, very important in your fifth semester DBMS projects. J text fields, where you are creating forms for registering users, okay, for getting data from the users, you are using what? J text fields. What is this J text field? Let me show you here. This is your J text field. See, this is your text field. J text field. Okay, so you can create text field like this. Then you can have a label around here, so which says that like username. Then here the text field without any text. Then just you run it, you will get this kind of GUI where you can type whatever you want. But this is what single lines. There is no multiple lines. You cannot have multiple lines. If you press enter, nothing will happen. Single line you can edit. Okay, so this is what your text field. It is very helpful in creating forms. Okay, now see, J J text field allows you to edit one line of text. The three constructors are, first, J text fields, int number of columns. Number of columns means actually number of characters. Number of characters. See here, in this design, this first character is called first column. Second character is called second. Third character, third column. See, if you just see, if I write first column, this is what first character is, first column, second column, third column. Okay, then fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. Okay, this is number of columns. So actually here what I have done is drag and drop. So here I have set the size to 241 size. 241 means 237 means what? 237 characters it can hold in this text field. So okay, then second constructor where you are passing two arguments, string and number of columns. String means the information that you want to display on your text field by default. Okay, and the size of the text field. See how to display. We have this text field. What you need to do is you need to go to this property. This is drag and drop option. You can use this in your hard coding. You need to use the constructor. Okay, how it is going to work? See the message that you want to pass. Enter example, enter username. Okay, then the size is 15. Understood? Size is 15 or 150. Okay, you can have a like this. Okay, so in drag and drop options, what you need to do is you need to go to property of this, then here you will have your text. In this, enter user name, close. Then if you just run it, while it is running, it will show you this information that you have already seen in your forms and all. When you click on it, this is automatically disappearing, right? That we need to write an action command for that. So I have not written, that's why it is not disappearing. So you can just select it all and delete it, and you can have your own information. Okay, so this is what the second constructor was. Third one, last, only the string size doesn't matters. So here size will be according to your string size. Okay, now JText field generates events in response to user interactions. Okay, see, this is very, very important. And if you understand the thing here, the assignment that I am going to give, the next assignment that I am going to give, it will be very easy for you. Okay, so we'll see a program on page number 882 to handle JText field events. 882. So what we are doing, we are importing the AWT contents, then AWT event handling for event handlings, then swing components for JApplets. See, public class textfield demo extends JApplet. JTextfield you are creating a new text field here, and the text field name is JTF. Text field variable name is JTF. See, variable name is different and a text on the text field, it is different. See here, for this text field, the variable name is, if you want to go know variable name, or you can go to just properties, or you can have window like this over here. See code, the variable name is JTextField1. In our code, in author's code, it was JTF. You can set here variable name to, instead of JTextField1, to JTF like this. Okay. Now, after you have set the here variable and the text information that you are getting here, enter user, it is what, in string on the JText field. Okay, don't get confused. Variable is different and the string is different on a JText field. So it is a variable. Now you are creating a event dispatcher thread, then you are calling make GUI. See, make GUI is a user defined method. You can have your own method. It is not necessary that always you should have make GUI method. Okay, make GUI. Then you are having a layout is what, flow layout, that I have already explained in the previous video. Here you are creating a JText field with a size 15. Then you are adding that text field to your content pane, then you are adding a listener to that. What you are doing in the listener, action performed, if enter is pressed, the message that it is having in the text field, that message should be get the text on this text field and show into the status bar. Let me first run this code for you and show you the output. here we need to have a new class, and the class name will be JTextful Demo. JTextField Demo. So if I run this code, see, whenever I am typing here hello and press enter, it is showing the information on status bar. Then if I write AITM, then enter, showing on the status bar. Okay, this is how JTextField works. Okay, so this will be a small video. In this we have already studied JLabel, image icon and JTextfields. Understood? So in next class we are going to study four types of swing buttons, and for all those four types the examples for that, then different usual components. Okay, up to then, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.